At Bethany Church, we have a long history of supporting missions. Some of those missions are local, such as Operation Blessing or Seacoast Family Promise. Others are scattered around the world. And while we have a worldwide reach, we do have areas of focus, and one of those is the South American nation of Bolivia. Here in Bolivia, we support Bruce and Miriam Salde in La Paz, Paul and Lucinda Bentley in Cochabamba, Hernan Rana in El Dorado, and our newest Bethany missionary, Yeri Arnold, here in Kotoka. Our call is to be disciples making disciples, and that call of Jesus really has no geographic bounds. It might be you meeting with a friend over breakfast to share your faith and help them grow in theirs. It might be coming to a place like this and being part of a missionary team. One of the ways in which everybody can support missions is through the offering that's taken each week on both campuses. You see, 10% of the overall budget of Bethany Church goes to the support of missions, both local and worldwide. So when the offering plate goes by, you have a chance to make a difference each and every week. Another way in which people make a difference in missions is to get on a plane and come to a place like this as part of a short-term missions team. Back in 2004, the first of several small short-term missions teams came here to Kotoka, rolled up their sleeves, got their hands dirty, invested their time, talent, and treasure to build this small church. Construction of this building began in 2004, and the church did open. It was open for several years, but ultimately faltered. And for the last few years, it has been sitting empty with no worship services. Earlier this year, I was in the city of Tarija meeting with Reverend Yeri Arnold of our partner church, Ecclesia Tarija. And in our conversation, Yeri expressed to me the fact that he believed that God was calling him here to reopen this church. God had put this place and this church on his heart, and he just couldn't shake it. And he asked, would Bethany be willing to financially come alongside and make it possible for him to be here? We are taking on a similar challenge in Kittery Point, and I thought, what a great parallel opportunity that we have to do the exact same thing in the nation of Bolivia. Yeri has now relocated here to Kotoka, and there's the beginning of a pulse of life and activity here in this building. Kids come by, parents come by, as they are reintroduced to the church and its new presence. You might be wondering, well, what can I do about this? As you can see behind me, there are parts of this building that aren't done and need to be completed. There are lots of things that need to happen here. There needs to be a fence. We need to put in a water tank. There's lots of opportunities. There are going to be a series of short-term missions teams coming here to Kotoka over the course of the next 2 years. The first one just a month away at the end of July. Would you be willing to be a part of one of those teams? Would you be willing to pray if that's something that God would have you do? Bring the talents that you have. You don't need to reinvent yourself. Be who God has made you and come and be a part of bringing this church back to life. If you're interested, please contact me. If you can't come and you're thinking, I wish I could make a difference, would you be willing to be a financial supporter for those who are able to come to maybe help buy some supplies? We're going to rock the world for Jesus in Kittery Point. And we have the opportunity as Bethany Church, both in Greenland and Raymond, to do the exact same thing, not only outside of our zip codes, but outside the boundaries of our country, here in Kotoka. I hope you'll consider that and that you'll be a part of the effort to bring Jesus to this community.